Hi, Chris here for Tenkatech. Welcome to my channel. Today we are going to have a look at my new AMD CPU. It will be just an unboxing. So let's get started. So as you can see, it's a box for a second gen and not a third gen AMD Ryzen CPU. And yes, it's a 7 series. So which one will it be? Let's try to see if I can do a close up. Oh yeah, there is an X at the end. So it's a 2700X Ryzen CPU. Okay, so let's open the box. To me, that sound is satisfying. Alright, so when you open, what you see first? Well, not really exciting, I opened the wrong side. It's the cooler. On the side, you will find the CPU. Alright, so as you can see, there is not much to it. So let's put that on the side, remove this, and see what else on the box. Oh, not that. Just a piece of cardboard, and yeah, it's empty. So we don't need that. Let's put it on the side and concentrate on the cooler. Yes, I keep the best for the end. Alright, so remove the cover, and now the CPU. You can see the thermal paste is already applied, so be careful. Alright, once you have this on your fingers, it's quite difficult to remove. At the bottom, however, you have two cables, one for controlling the fan, the other one the RGB. Let's put back the cover and go to the front of the fan. Ah, that way better. Yeah, much better. For this, you will think that those are holes, but actually no, it's just plastic. Right here you have the speed controller. It's a dial, actually a switch, yes, just for low and high. If you can see, yeah, low. Now it's on low. I will leave it on low for myself. Here you have some covers. Let's remove this and see what's underneath. All right oh, the first one that I remove was for the RGB, yes, correct, and the second one is for the USB. Here we can see clearly the four copper pipes, that's for the cooling, and that's pretty much all for the cooler. Not to worry, because now on the side I'm not putting the cooler back in the box, and we can start with what's interesting actually. Let's remove that. So for the CPU, once you open the box, you will find inside sticker and the CPU as well as at the manual. Let's start by looking a little bit at the CPU, a little bit closer. Yeah, that's about it. At the back, you have the pins, different than Intel. The pins are in the motherboard for the Intel one, but for AMD, the pins are on the CPU. That's the manual. You can pause here if you want to. There is not much to see. As you will see on my install or in my review, it was very bad. So that's all for now, guys. I really thank you. I didn't remove the CPU, but here you have a little bit of B-roll for you. I will take it out of the box fast, not to worry. You've been patient enough just for this unboxing. Alright? So the pins, as I was saying, and that's it. If you want to see the build without missing anything, you can subscribe and press the bell button. So thank you for watching. If you like this video, you know what to do. If you don't like, please do leave a comment down below and tell me why. So that's it for now, and thank you for watching. Bye guys.